Righteous work, guys.
Righteous teachings we a tear down the works of the wicked ones. Oh, words of truth, words of life, words that came from the Most High. He came to set the captives free tonight. He came to tear down prison walls, bring life. He came to set them free, let them be, resurrect and heal. Give them love, no retreat, wow. So give me the rhythm, let me free the little youths here from destruction. And give me the words, yeah, let me free the old man here from perversion. Give me the truth, Lord, let me lead the ghetto youths them out of Babylon. Oh, with righteous teachings, tear up, tear up. From perversion, just give me the truth and let me lead the ghetto youths them out of Babylon. With righteous teachings, we are tear down the works of the wicked ones.
Let you down, down, down. instead of putting up a fight. And you fi treat the youths right. And you be playing with dynamite. And you fi treat the youths right, 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 right.
Well, you know what time it is. Yeah, man, it's Sunday evening, 4 to 6 in the mix with your boy Wayne Studdard alongside. I got one of my partners with me today, and we're going to rock you with righteous reggae music all the way through to 6. Yeah, man, 4 to 6 in the mix, you don't know. Yeah, and you know, we're just going to big up all the people out there who've been vibing to the music and you've been enjoying the vibe. We just came out of African Safari. Yeah, man, we're going to keep it, drum and bass. Drum and bass is the vibe, you know. Yeah, you know, we Afro people love the drum and bass vibe. So we're going to really, really just keep the music going for you right now. Today, we have a special guest who's going to be coming in on the lines. And we want to sound off today to let you know that Aston Barrett Jr. is going to be calling in from the Wailers. Yeah. Sebony. But the people are going to say there, man. Yeah, we're missing one, but we're still live.
I'm here.
Yes, we're here. Yeah, I got Sebony with me today. And I want to big up Tom for holding the vibe down, you know. That's my wingman right here. Tom in the house, salute, man. Bless up. And I want to say to the entire WMNF family, you know, we got coming up later on is the Righteous Temple of Hip Hop, you know, Tempest and the crew. I want to salute all of those people out there who are DJs, who are giving off their time to give you this sweet entertainment that you get day after day, night after night. Yeah, we burn the midnight oil to make sure that you got that vibe, that energy that's going to keep you going for the rest of your day. Well, I'm not going to talk to you too much. I'm not going to keep you too... I want to just tell you, please, can you do me a favor? Do DJ Wayne a favor. Sebony, ask me what's the favor.
What's the favor?
The favor is that I want you to tell a friend that the Righteous Rockers experience is on. We're going to give you the numbers. We want to make sure that you are locked in with what's going on today because we got what we call it, reggae royalty in the house.
Yes, yes. You don't want to miss it.
Reggae royalty. Listen, call up your neighbor. Tell them, say, yo, the Wheelers is about to touch down in Tampa Bay. And that's no joke, right? So we know that Aston Barrett is the son of Aston Barrett Sr., family man popularly known. And we know that this gentleman has just came off the movie set for the Bob Marley and the Wailers that's dropping next year, 2024. Yep. So we got a lot to talk about. So you definitely don't want to miss this show. All right, we're going to keep the music going. And as we talk about the Wailers and we talk about the MD for the Wailers, we're going to keep it going with the king of reggae music. You heard earlier from one that Aston actually worked on. And we're going to talk about the producer side. We're going to talk about the musician side. We're going to talk about the history. How does the Wailers as a band, Sebony, manage to maintain relevancy over how much decades that? Yo, that are from 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, now 2020, 2023. And they got a Grammy nominated in 2020.
That's just waiting.
I want you to tell a friend that we're going to be talking about this thing today, that Aston is in the studio and you're going to get a chance to really hear him speak about the legacy and the reggae royalty vibe and how it has been preserved over the years. Bless up. We're about to keep the music going. I said you heard from Steve Marley, one that Aston was a part of, and it's called False Friend earlier, and you heard from Jimmy Cliff saying treat the youths right. You don't know, treat the youths right. Now you're going to hear from the Bob Marley and the Wailers from the Uprising album with a tune called Forever Loving Jah. Salute.
Some things they see that Overflow.
Yes, yes, yes. You just heard from Butcher Banton alongside Morgan Heritage, the voice of Gramps Morgan. Yeah, man. And before that, you heard from Bob Marley and the Wailers. We be forever loving Ja. Forever loving Ja is the name of that track from the Uprising album. And I keep shouting it out because I want you not to miss out on this real reggae royal experience. Yeah, man. We have Aston Barrett Jr., you know, standing by to call Troop on the line. And then we want to make sure that everyone in the Tampa Bay area get a chance to really enjoy this moment in time. Talk to me, Sebony. Give them the number so them can know how to reach us and let us know how the vibe is coming across. Yeah.
Yeah, man. Definitely we want you to tell a friend and tell the friend to tell a friend. Yes. You know, if you're in the Tampa Bay area, we know it's WMNF, you know, Tampa 88.5. Mm-hmm. But you can always reach out to them to tell them to check us out online at WMNF.org. You may have a question or curious about something when Aston Barrett Jr. is on the air. You may text us or email us. You can email us at dj@wmnf.org, or you may text us at 813-433-0885. That's email with your question to dj@wmnf.org or text to 813-433-0885.
Yeah, man. And we want to hear from you because all the questions that you have, text us. Come on, whatever you have to ask Aston before he, you know, you get a chance to hear what he's going to give us a full update. Tour, musical production, you know, history of the music, you know, movie, all the things that has been going on, and so much has been going on. Nominated Grammy Award and working on another album. We want to get all the updates. So tell a friend that we're on right now. Here's one from the Wailers. It's called Philosophy of Life, featuring Paul Anthony. Big tune.
Sometimes it's better to let go and let fly. Why do we choose to do the things that's wrong when it feels good to do right? Though it seems the world will never change, people have to learn from their mistakes. Love and happiness ain't hard to find. That's my philosophy of life.
Brought me into this world with love and devotion. And the same way me love me queen for protect her emotion. They don't say that we have no respect. And even when I'm wrong, my girl keeps me in check. Aye. Some people say I'm foolish, but you know say that I'm wise. Got man smart, but woman smarter every time. So if you think you're clever, I suggest you take time. Or else the one you love might just leave you behind. Of life. A happy spouse is a happy house. Come make me sure the one loves a vow. When the winter she makes me feel like heaven in the sky.
I'm gonna give me some love.
One way, it doesn't matter what you believe. Some things have to change. One way. When you wake up, you look, look yourself in the mirror. Doesn't matter who are you or where you come from, man or woman, no worry, no fear. Full of surprises, life can change in a minute. Give a kiss to the one that you love, cause the world turns one way, just one way.
Why people see what they wanna see? Why people hear what they wanna hear? Why people feel what they wanna feel? The blue sky covers us like a single skin. Why people see what they wanna see? Why people hear what they wanna hear? Why people feel what they wanna feel? The blue sky covers us like a skin.
Creando el mundo unido, una sola nación. Aunque no importa la raza, tampoco el color. Levántame la mano que vive el amor. De Puerto Rico a Miami, de Jamaica hasta Cuba. Enciende la pipa y la pata, le menea la cintura. Que este reggae tropical te suba la temperatura. No coja lucha con nadie y nunca pierda la cordura.
Porque la gente siempre va a hablar. Y no te dejen llevar nunca del que dirá. Porque nunca vas a quedar bien con todo el mundo. Aprovecha que la vida cambia en tan solo segundos. La vida gozar.
No more hate, no more hate, no more hate. Yes, that's a big tune from the legendary Wailers. Yeah, man. Yeah, this one feature a lot of people on the cast. You know, Skip Marley, yes, Sidella Marley, Shaggy. Yeah, man, and the unconquerable Wailers. Yeah, we have on the line standing by. Yeah, man, the reggae royalty in the house, Tampa Bay. I like how, you know, the numbers up and all, the lights are blinking and everything. You know, get your question ready. We got Aston Barrett Jr. on the line coming straight at you. Give the numbers out again for me, Sebony. Let's talk.
Yeah, definitely. If you have a question or something that you'd like to find out about Aston Barrett Jr., who's a part of the Wailers, you could send us an email to dj@wmnf.org or text to 813-433-0885.
Wicked and wild. Yeah, man. So, fams, you know, we're gonna talk to him. Right now, you just heard from two of the songs that were taken from the Grammy-nominated album, actually. And we're just going to bring the man in right after this tune. Yeah, we are going to play one who come from a big, 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 big production table. It features the man called Mr. Alberosi and also Mr. Chronix. So, yeah, well, we are going to play this and then we are come back at the next vice. So, yeah, we're going to be talking to Aston Barrett Jr. Sin. So stay tuned and tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend that we on with the biggest show on a Sunday evening, 4 to 6 in the mix. Wayne Stoddart at the control. Sibony, my wing lady right there,
yeah,
over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, bringing the vibe and the energy, and we are rocking you with righteous reggae music all evening. Sin, 4 to 6 in the mix. Check the vibe. Boom, bang.
Listen to me now, brother.
I weigh yourself.
Contradicting yourself.
Chronix, Alberosi, tell them, say.
Listen to me now.
Contradiction is global.
Yeah. Contradiction global. The madness taking over. Too much man in a mix up. One bag a mix up. Rasta and a lips up.
Contradiction.
this a buy out a wallet. Well, got a 6 for a 9 and a 9. You know the waste, then a sentence to life, cause
contradiction global, a madness taking over. Too much man in a mix up, one bag a mix up, Rasta and a lips up.
Contradiction global, still good conquer evil. David still sugar lawyer, make one wall a vibe, yeah. Well, Margarita no flunker. Shots there, he might do it from a mansion.
Slowly,
like cancer spread out. I'll got them take out. Politician and gunman a link. So contradiction, run the thing, yeah.
A contradiction global, the madness taking over. Too much man in a mix up, one bag a mix up. So small, two faced, two more, two light. Nothing like a living two lives. Yeah. Too good, yeah, too bad, and you're the one two sides. People don't know what to choose.
One love and one heart where the art there. Nowadays, you must be heartless.
Another big tune, yeah man, featuring Wailers and of course Aston Barrett Jr. himself, you know. The man is on the line, Tampa Bay. Are you ready for the epic moment? Yeah. Oh my goodness. Guess what? We got the band that has dominated rockers music over the years. The MD is right here live on WMNF 88.5 on your FM dial with your boy Wayne and Sebony.
Yeah, definitely. Send in your questions. We got a few coming in already, but stay tuned.
Yes. So let's connect the man himself, you know, the general himself. Yes, and we want to talk to the man Aston Barrett Jr. and just kind of bring in the vibe, you know, and let the people know that, you know, we have that energy and he's coming to really tell a little bit and give you a little bit more information about the music and the man behind the music and the legend and the whole family of the Wailers. Hear the vibe. Fams, are you out there? Can you hear me, brother?
Yeah, man, I can hear you.
Yes, beautiful, loud and clear. You're coming through and Tampa Bay is enjoying the vibe right now. So guess what, man? We just want to welcome you to the Righteous Rockers
experience, my family. Welcome.
Big up. Yo, the Wailers is probably the most touring band in the world, you know, brother. Where you are on the globe right now? Talk to me.
Well, I tell you, man, we're in Texas now, Austin, Texas.
My goodness, man, you guys are always on the road. We've been getting some nice love from Tampa Bay. They love the vibe, they love the energy. We've been playing some tracks from the One World album. I wonder if you can tell me a little bit about that, the whole production, mm-hmm. and how did that come about and how far did you guys get with that? Talk to me.
Yeah, man, the One World album was definitely a new breakthrough for Wailers because, you know, after Bob Marley passed, you know, transcend.
Mm-hmm.
In 1981, the last album came out after that was Confrontation.
Wow. Mm.
So my father told me that basically he couldn't really get back that sound, because, you know, the band was there, but Bob is the messenger, so
yes.
He was always looking for that. He came out with, you know, some albums, but it just never had the same essence.
That so. Energy, yes, I.
Yeah. Mm. Years and years go by, and then when he retired, and he said, all right, son, I need you to run the band. My job is to preserve the music and make sure it keeps getting higher.
So, hold on, may I stop you on some key points? And they just said, Aston Barrett Sr., the bassist, and the man behind the engineer of the Wailers music, said to you, say, son, step up now, your time, reggae royalty. Whoa.
yeah, man.
Yes.
You know, in trusting me and in training me over the years, and saw the interest as well. Because you have to have the interest, you know.
Yeah. It's not just the bloodline alone. You have to have the gifting of the Most High, and then the interest. You have to have a passion, right?
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
So, because everything short is, he and Bob Marley wanted to have a producer.
Yes.
And they couldn't get Quincy Jones. Quincy Jones, who produced Michael Jackson hit.
Wow.
Mm. They wanted him. So what they did was learn and study the albums and learn how to produce their self, even though they wanted, you know. But then you had Chris Blackwell from Island Record, who was also a good person for them to show them modern stuff.
Yes.
So, you know, as I took over the band, it's like the energy of everyone just came in, and, you know, and you trust in the Almighty.
Yes, sir.
That's just where everything moved. And we got, you know, called to do a show, and they said, Estefan, and that's where it started. And first time I met Gloria Estefan and Emilia Estefan, and we did the show.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, could our daughter, Emily, come jam with you? I would do a rehearsal and realize that, man, the girls don't like Gloria.
it was
so good. So
yes.
All right, no problem. So we did it.
Yes.
And Emilio came to me and said, you know, I've heard reggae music, but I never really hear it on this level. Like, this is something. He's like, what are you guys doing? I said, yeah, we're just here.
Wow.
Next thing you know, we get a meeting that he wants to meet with me.
Mm-hmm.
So I went and meet with him, and he said, I want to produce an album for you. And I said, what? So, you know, I told my father. My father said, listen, Bob and I wanted Quincy Jones.
Mm-hmm.
I have an open mind. Don't listen to anyone.
Yes.
This is your opportunity. This is how you're going to preserve the music.
Mm.
Bob and I would definitely approve. So go ahead. And we did it. And it was a success. And we got nominated, you know?
Yes. Wicked. Yo, I love the story. You know, that's one thing we kind of prize ourselves on, Aston. And in case you just joined the show, we are talking to Aston Barrett Jr. of the Wailers, the MD and the son of the legendary Aston family man Barrett, the man who is carrying the torch and bringing this righteous reggae vibe and upholding not just the sound, the man upholding the sound and the message. And that is the other question. Because Carmen had a question. So
yes.
Aston, Carmen had a question. This is a local. Tampa local, and she wanted to drop something and figure out this mystic thing about the mystic Wailers. Talk to me, Sebony.
yes, Aston, welcome to the show. So Carmen, she asks, how do you stay relevant in such a rapidly changing environment? How do you keep the music and the message and the vibe relevant to today?
Well, you know, that's a good question, you know, because it's funny you said that. You know, some people came in the band and was saying, this is the mission of Bob Marley.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to continue this mission and of a thing about this and thing about that.
Mm-hmm.
But my father, Familyman Barrett, told me, regardless of that, you have to sing more about love.
Wow, I love that.
I wanted to preach more love and unity in the world now.
Wow.
So I said, well, Daddy, there is no, but there's a lot of things going on in the world. You might have to listen to me. Bob Marley and myself and your uncle fought all the battles for you guys already.
Wow.
You want to talk about these things? It's already in the songs. Just songs.
That's powerful. Wow.
But anything new you're doing, you look on what you can push more forward. Saving the earth, eat wow. organic food. We need more yes. families to be united. We need more of the you know, mothers and fathers into the kids' life. You know, there's too much things going on, too much people separating. It's just, it's an off balance. So we, that is our message, that we have to continue in this time. But the greatest thing, there's a Bob Marley and the Wailers song for almost everything you go through in life.
True, you know, true. Yes, I, facts. Yes, I.
Yeah. So, you know, it's there, man. So that's why, because their music has no category.
True.
It's not old, it's not new, it's just there.
Yes. Music. Music.
Yes,
as we say, music, all over shall live. Yeah, yeah, man. Exactly. So now we're going to go to a tune where, you know, we have here that, you know, you worked on with Albert Rosie, and then we come back and talk a little bit more about music. This one feature Beres Amman, saying, boom, bang. Everybody, right. You're tuned in to Righteous Rockers Experience. I got my boy, Aston Barrett Jr. from the Wailers live on the line, and we talking about the man behind the music and the mission of the music of the Wailers. Check this vibe. All right, that's another one you just heard from Aston Barrett Jr. And, you know, it's alongside Alberosi and Beres Hammond. Beresford Hammond. So Aston, boy, the lines of people are loving this talk and getting, you know, the up close and personal conversation with you, Big General. But we want to know, tell me something. Who are some of the people that you have worked with in the music industry? And just give us a little bit of your catalog and who you have worked with in the music industry so far in the reggae world. Or whichever world, talk to it.
In the reggae world,
yes,
all of the Marley family, you know, we're like family.
Yes,
Julian Marley.
Wow,
started me out really, because I was working with Julian since I was in eighth grade in middle school.
Yes, yes. Whoa, what? Yeah, hold on. That just registered a while ago. You said eighth grade in middle school. Yo,
man.
Yo,
I didn't record on the album, but I was rehearsing.
Yes.
And he gave me a few... Actually, it's so funny. He taught me more things about my father, like back in the past, like about the Upsetters and the Hippie Boys and Youth Professional.
Yes.
So my father banned from back in those days. So he burned CDs for me to listen, because all I really knew was Bob Marley and the Wailers, Peter Tosh and Bunny Wailer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a few other people, Greg Rizak and Dennis Brown. That's what my father did, like Black Cinderella and...
Yes.
Stick by me in a stick.
Hold on, man. Yo. You see where you're at there? Now you start dig up some of your daddy catalog and you make me all curious now, because enough people Familyman Senior only work on Wailers tune. But you call out some big tune now. You call out John Holt and some big names. So give me some of the cats, some tunes where people probably would not know that your daddy work on. Talk to me about that, because we have to bring in Father Fams too, you know.
Yeah, man. Well, Lonely Lover. From Greg Rizak.
Greg Rizak. What?
Yeah, man. My father, one of Dennis Brown's first hits, and one of... what's his name again? Freddie McGregor first hit. It's my father, and you know, play them, and Carly play some of them. There was a band called the Uniques, which was Jimmy Riley, which is Taurus Riley's father. My father, one of his first bass line he recorded for a producer named Stryker Lee.
Stryker Lee, big producer, yes.
Yeah, man. And the song called Watch the Sound. Stop, children. Yeah, man. So,
wow.
Bob Marley went to Chris Blackwell, and Chris Blackwell said, you need a band.
Yes.
So, Bob Marley said, I've been hearing these brothers out there that I really want.
Yes.
And this is like 1969, and Bob was a fan of the Barrett Brothers, but the Barrett Brothers was a fan of Bob Marley.
See, divine works, man. Aja works.
Yeah, man. So when they came together, that's where it was, you know. So that's how that happened. But, so Julian Marley, maybe know about that. I work on his album called Awake. That was the first album I did. And then I did Stephen Marley album. I did drums, two track called False Friend.
Yes.
Another one called Hail Selassie, the Chapel. I played drums on those two.
Dope. Nice.
And then... Damian Marley's latest album, Stony Hill.
Yes.
I produced the track called The Struggle Discontinue, which is track number 11.
Yes.
Drum, bass, keyboard, all kind of thing.
Whoa. Yo. That is another thing, you know, fam. So what instruments do you play, brother? Because we need to find that out, fams, JR.
Yeah.
Talk to me.
All right. For instance, is when I know that, from I was younger, I knew I had to play. I had to study Wailers. So what happened is, in order for me to teach Wailers song, I have to learn the thing. So majority of everything I learned from my father.
Mm-hmm.
But I was fortunate enough to learn from some of the guys before they passed. Earl Wyalindo, the original organ player, and the great Tyrone Downey.
Wow.
So I was very fortunate to learn. I didn't meet my uncle, but I learned his style from, you know, because he and my father, brothers.
Yeah, so they train together, they practice together.
Mm. Yeah. Also, I play drum, keyboard, bass is my real instrument. Drum is second, but mostly reggae drums is for me.
Yes.
I could do anything on bass, but drums,
Reggae.
Reggae is really my strongest point, but I can still do anything.
Well, I know just from observing there and watching the information that's out there that even at one point in time, you played bass with some American artists, you know, because in your early years, you was rocking with one of them Grammy artists I wrote, a female artist. You can't, I would that.
Yeah, man, it's so funny. It's so funny, man. Yeah, Lauryn Hill.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I did 2 years with her, 2011 and 2012.
Yes.
I did
yes.
all the Rock the Bells. That was amazing, man. He is so amazing to work with, and I've learned a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I was there too because she's very musical.
Mm-hmm.
She will push you to your limit. Just like when I, you know, when I was in jazz band, cause I went to a performing arts school in Fort Lauderdale called Dillard.
Yes.
Dillard Performing Arts. And my teacher name was Christopher Dorsey.
Wow.
Yeah, man. And
big up the teachers, you know? Music teachers. Yeah.
He bring me to the next level, man. It was rough. Rough. Looked like he was kind of mean, but he just wanted to push me.
Yeah.
Once I got to the level, he was like my best friend.
That's good. Yo, we're talking, in case you just join us on the show, you are tuned to the Righteous Rockers Experience, and we're having a really, really, what you call it, mind food, mind filling, and really entertaining conversation, which is full. Remember what we promise you on this show, that we inform, we inspire, and we entertain, and we educate. You are learning about the music and the magic behind the music from the man himself who has the information coming down from the ones who kind of set the pace. We know Daddy Wailers, you know, Aston Barrett Sr. and Carly Barrett and the whole, as he says, the whole family, cause Wire and all them guys and everybody, the man, to get a chance to really learn from the grits. And now you have preserved this legacy and you are taking it to the generation right now in 2023. You just call out a song, so we are going to play. You know, cause you have a tendency, you know, when you call out a tune, you know, say basically we have to salute and show some honor to it. So you call out. We played one from Stevens' album earlier, False Friend. That one, and I know you said that was one that you produced. But go ahead. You were saying something, Aston. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, you know, I was saying the other artists I worked with in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Wayne Marshall, Chronic.
Wow.
Jesse Royal.
What?
Yeah, man, I did some work for Raging Fire.
Yes.
Alba Rose. You heard Alba Rose.
Yes. Mm.
Yeah, man, so many other more that I don't know yet because I've done some work that don't come out yet.
Watch it.
For American artists, no, I would say I'm getting closer,
mm-hmm.
working with a lot more people from the country side, mm-hmm. but...
Nashville thing. Hold on. Yeah. We got to talk, you know what? We got to talk, man. We don't want to realize I'm out in Nashville.
Yeah, man. But to make everybody excited,
yes,
the Wailers album finally finished. We finished mixing the last track. And most of all the tracks are mastered. There's only one track needed to master, but they just finished mixing it a few days ago. And it's produced again by the great Emilio Estefan.
Wow.
Yeah, man. It's an honor.
Great.
So much from him. Yeah, man. You remind me of my father. But no matter what I do in this life,
mm-hmm.
you have to honor your parents. I used to, when you honor your mother and your father,
yes.
you will go far.
Far.
Honoring my father makes me where I am. Honoring your mother is where it's at, you know, because even when I used to play music and sometimes it's too loud. My mother used to be like, don't worry. At least he's not giving any trouble, you know?
Yes, he just playing music. Yeah.
And she was so good to the point to where she grew all of us up in such a great loving family. So no matter what we do, we go here and there, we're all a loving family. Like my brothers, they really look out for me. Even sometimes, them talk to me, I have to be like, hello, I'm a big man, you know, I'm a big man. But it's just the love that they have, and it's the way we are. My sisters, them are amazing too.
Wow.
You see?
Family.
Just, you know, and it's not saying we never go through struggles, because some people, they will look on us and, you know, think everything was glitter and gold, but the reason why we can play the music the way that we are.
It's been 26 minutes.
Hey, yeah. That?
Come on, big sure on the turntable, check it out. Fam's gonna drop this one and come right back at you, man. Yeah. Joining us and wondering what's going on, you're tuned to 88.5 on the FM dial, and we are here live with Aston Barrett Jr. from the Wailers on the turntable. Well, he's on the phones, you see. I'm so used to saying on the turntable music, but you know, he's on the phones, and you know, he's really giving us a real download on the journey for the Wailers as a Wailers family, as you know, the transition, and he's holding the baton now in 2023 and carrying and doing such a marvelous job. Just now, you know, the music kind of came in, you know, DJ just kind of flip up this tune when we are talking, so we apologize for that. But you know, Fams is going to come right back and just talk about his experience this year with the movie. Right after this break, we're going to come back and just talk about he plays a role, he's an actor in the Bob Marley movie that's coming out next year, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. We still want to hear your questions coming in. I see we have some mail coming in there. We're going to reach out to you. Go ahead and give the numbers again for me, Sebony, and then we can get back to this.
WMNF Tampa. So if you like to ask Aston Familyman Barrett Jr. a question, you can send an email to dj@wmnf.org or by texting to 813-433-0885.
All right. And Aston just mentioned a tune a while ago. We're going to play that one and then we're going to go right back to him. And then we just kind of bring the curtains down. We're going to talk about what's going on and what's going in the future. You hear him say the album just finished, the new Wailers album, exciting stuff coming at you. And this is one that he just mentioned just now that he worked on with Damian Marley called The Struggles Discontinues.
And I pray thee, why art thou continuing to struggle? struggle. Live it up, Jah.
Well, if the struggle continue, then when will we overcome? Right here and now, my struggling and prosperity from now on.
Yes, you are tuned to the Righteous Rockers Experience. Yeah, man, we're instead out at the control. I got my partner with me right here, Sebony at the control. Talk to me, Sebony. How the vibe?
Yeah, man, the vibe is going very well. If you're just joining us, we have the Aston Familyman Barrett Jr. on the line, sharing us his music, his experience, how he remains relevant. And we have coming up a section, a very exciting thing that we heard. Aston, are you there? We hear that you have a movie in the works. Hey, man, what's the name of that movie?
Yeah. Talk to it.
Yeah, man.
How did it feel to play? Who did you play in the movie, Aston?
Why, I played my father.
Wow. Without giving away any spoilers or anything, just talk about the experience, man.
What's the name of the movie?
Yeah,
them just announced it a few months ago, right? What name again? One Love.
Yes, yes. One Love. Yes.
Bob Marley, One Love, they call it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, originally when we was working on it, I mean, it looked like it was God named Exodus or something, you know, but yeah, when the final was One Love, it makes sense.
Makes sense.
It's the unity, you know.
Yes.
Did you have to do any training just to get into character? Was it natural for you? Like,
oh yeah,
how did that work? Did you have to do any physical changes? Like, tell us about the transformation for that role.
Wow. It was so funny. Doing rehearsal was one thing, but by the time them say, action! Like, we couldn't even talk no more.
Stage fright.
They have a bright light fire, and
stuff. I say, all kind of people in the room are look funny, and then them say, action and quiet is like, you could hear a pin.
Wow.
That's your joke, man.
Wow.
But we did take some acting class.
Beautiful.
We had 2 days a week in rehearsal. Then we had to go do acting. So Hector Lewis was playing Carlton Barrett. We really had to act like brothers. So basically, even when we were off the screen, we had to still be in character.
Yeah, wow. Maintain the synergy.
But the only funny thing is, too, I grew up with my father. I'm already similar to him.
Yeah.
But I know how him is, so to really act like him, it was interesting.
Wow.
It's like when the movie finished, I was finished.
Uh-huh.
The whole thing is like getting back into my character was a little bit difficult.
Wow.
So I can say how some people really act. Oh, you have to really be careful of the rules.
Yes.
As it really, you know, it really can come to you. But so in the beginning, I did an audition.
Mm-hmm.
A few people reached out to me before, and I said, they might make a Bob Marley movie, but I always hear about it, so I didn't take it seriously until, funny or not, Albert Rosie called me and said, there's somebody that I know that is one of the cast directors. Her name was Corrine. She's going to reach out to you. The man said, Aston, please just audition because you are the rightful one. I said, I don't want to do it because, you know, it's just, we don't know if it's real.
Yeah.
I said, it's real. Please.
Wow.
So I said, all right.
Thank you, Alba Rosie.
Yeah. So she called me, and then we talked to her, and then she told me the procedures.
Yes.
And we did the procedures and did the audition, and she showed me the angles them were for do. So we did all of that and sent it in, make sure it was high quality. So I needed someone to speak as Bob.
Yes.
So nobody could speak as Bob now. So my empress now, she videotaped me and then she used her phone. So me go do the voiceover, I'm sorry, me I go talk like Bob now, so me just go say, yeah man, you don't know any family man, you don't know about Marley, you know?
Oh my goodness.
Yeah man.
You sound like the man boss.
Well, you know, I was going to go to school to do voice, you know, try and impersonate people, but that was an undercover thing.
Yes.
So we did it, and when I sent it in, she called me back and said, yo, who you get Bob Marley for? How you do that? I said, me. She said, how are you, Ross? I said, yo.
Wow.
Cut that short. We sent it in. So I never really hear nothing. So I still wasn't taking it seriously.
Yes.
Until I got a text from Sidella now. Sidella said, hey, the Bob Marley movie, you know. Them have all kind of audition, but why you try audition for your father?
Wow.
So when she texts me now, I say, okay.
That's serious.
Wow.
Serious now. So I say, all right. I'm tell her, I say, well, I did audition, so I just sent her back the same tape as well. And then, so it was already in, so, you know, them get it on both sides.
Beautiful.
So whoever was trying to audition for daddy, they would have done good, because, you know, but the thing about this is they told me that my acting skills was natural. I don't know if I can act or not because I never went to school for it. But whatever I did, they said it was good. And when I did the acting class, the teacher really said both myself and Hector really did really good.
Yes.
So when it was time to act, first day was funny. But after a while, we got used to it.
Get into it, eh?
Yeah, and yeah. He had actors there already, such as Tustin.
Mm-hmm.
And the one who playing, he's playing Tyrone, and then you have the one who play Bob.
Mm-hmm.
He play, and Lasandra. So Lasandra was in Woman King. And
yes. Yeah, big actor. Yeah, man. I know she was. Yeah. Yeah, man. Mm.
Kingsley did the Malcolm X thing, though.
Yes.
The Netflix one, too.
Yes, yes, yes. So,
it was really nice. So watching them, I learn every day, and it's like them going to crying mode, and then them come out of the crying mode. Man, I said, wait, how them do that?
Yeah. Welcome to the world of acting, musician.
Mister, one of the scenes that my daddy, you know, me almost cried. Thank God I'm never on the glass. I feel it, you know, and then them just turn around and just start smiling. Man, I said, no, stop.
Wow.
It's yeah. Acting DNA, man. You got your foot wet, though.
So when is the movie coming out, Aston?
I think them says January 14th, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
So it will be around that time, but 2024.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's going to shock the world, and majority of it is really, you know, I would say it's one of the truest stories.
Depiction,
biopic.
Yes.
Definitely.
Yes. Well, fams, I tell you what, man, this has been inspirational. It's very, been informative. Very it's been educational and entertaining.
Yes.
Because, you know, the musical catalogue with the man of, boy, if we play this, we are going to need about 10 shows for done. Your catalogue.
Yes. You're good, man. But if you must know.
Yes.
Mr. Wayne Studdard.
Yes, sir.
I produced Wayne Studdard's album, Freedom Plan.
Yes, sir.
The one before it is written.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's always a pleasure working with you, Wayne.
Always a pleasure.
I love your works and proud of you and your family and keep up the great work.
Yes, I.
Yeah, man. And the last song that just came out was by Damian Marley again called Sweet Lord.
Yes.
Yeah, I played drums and bass. And really,
wow,
just came out a few months ago. So,
yes,
if you guys want to check it out?
Yeah, man, absolutely. You don't know. I want everybody to know that you are hearing these insights on the Righteous Rockers experience for the first time. Them thing you're not talking about, but not other show, them thing you just happen right here. So Tampa Bay, you're privileged. You're in the presence of reggae royalty,
yes,
the man
yes.
himself, Aston Barrett Jr., unfolding all the secrets of the music and telling you about what is to come, movie-wise and music-wise. So wow, we're gonna keep up with it, Aston. We're not gonna let you down. We're gonna drop that tune there. If we don't find it this week, it released yet or it not released yet? The tune that I just mentioned.
It released.
My sweet lord.
You're fine, you know.
All right, cool. Yeah, so we're gonna search. We're gonna have the DJ dig it up, and we're gonna make sure so we drop that. And of course, we're gonna do a salute to you. And thanks again for really taking the time out to hang out with us here on the Righteous Rockers Experience. Man, I know you're busy. I know you got 10 million things going on, but you say, yo, salute to the Righteous Rockers Experience, and you have started the ball rolling, man. We just give you a humble bow and say salute, my brethren.
Salute.
Listen, salute and respect here, sir.
Salute.
One love. Man. Take care.
Yeah, one love.
Covenant. Yeah, man. Guidance and protection. Blessing. Yes, that was Aston Barrett, the man himself, just giving us all that intriguing talk and just bringing us through the whole Wailers experience, the journey over the decades, and preparing you for what is to come. And we're going to play one that is produced by the man himself as we switch over to the Righteous Rockers Gospel Hour, and it's from yours truly, produced by Aston Barrett Jr. Music Alone.
Shot I lick, shot down Babylon, for I chose ridiculous to sing to that same song. But we will never bow to Nebuchadnezzar. No, we will never bow to none of the idols. Whoa. The righteous alone shall live. The righteous alone shall live. Children of Zion, step into that Beulah.